Hello, Mr. Wagner. We hope we aren't interrupting anything.
Oh, no, it's fine. Just a power core that needs some work done into it, but someone else can look into that.
Ah, okay, so Mr.
I prefer if you called me Dr. Wagner. I didn't get my diploma for nothing.
Oh, I see. Well, Dr. Wagner, we came here so that you could tell us about this new energy source that you found a few months ago.
Mist. Well, it all started in a nearby mine. Our diggers opened up an air pocket that released a form of gas.
Gas!
At first, everyone was like, oh no, deadly gas, that's something, but then we realized we were entirely off.
How so?
Well, this dust, it had this almost limitless supply of electrons. It could power a basic city generator for more than 10 years.
So why did you call it dust?
Well, as I said, the miners thought it was some sort of gas. But one of the smarter little miners out there said it resembled a form of dust. Thus, the name for fruit.
So where does mist come into play?
Mist. How do I word this? Let's just say it's Dust's older brother. It has a lot more energy source, but it drains far quickly. Whereas Dust powers city generators for about 10 years, mist runs out from as short as 1 year to 7 months.
So what do you use it for? Backup?
Actually, Dust is the backup. Dust is a lot harder to come by, where mist is a lot more easier to find. Of course, it does have some problems in there.
Problems?
Okay, don't go gasping for air or something. That's here, so long as it's monitored. If not, well...
What was that?
The problem. If this stuff reacts with enough oxygen, like a hell of a lot, the thing will explode in our hand. Your hand's gone. We've determined that it's made of human materials. If I don't leave, I'd be going to lose a portion of the lab.
Anything else you can tell us?
Only if I don't leave now, I'm going to lose a lot of our research. So it was nice to meet you. I need to go.